morning, sir.
Good morning, dear. Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, dear. So today we are starting a new genus, that is Vaucheria. Okay, we have already discussed about the brief introduction of this class Gentophyceae. But when you will see the classification, you will see a difference, clear cut difference between the classification proposed by Fritsch and classification proposed by Lee. According to Fritsch, this particular genus belongs to Chlorophyceae and the order Siphonaceae family Vaucheriaceae, whereas Lee placed it altogether in different phylum, that is Heterocontophyta, class Gentophyceae, and then order Vaucherias. So actually, it is one of the most discussed genus among phycologists regarding its taxonomic position. So you can see there are actually three thought of school who always claim that this particular genus belongs to that particular category. So this person, you can assume that he had been Fritsch, and why he kept Vaucheria and Chlorophyceae? Because of these characters: multinucleate, aseptate thallus, and oogamous type of sexual reproduction. Whereas, according to Lee, he believed that Vaucheria belongs to Gentophyceae because of siphonous, cinocytic, acellular organization of the thallus, discoid chloroplast, cell wall composition, food reserve, and heterocone flagella. And according to Lee, if anything is having heterocone flagella, that cannot belong to Chlorophyceae. That's why he kept it in class Gentophyceae of phylum Heterocontophyta near to brown algae. Apart from these two group of scientists who believe that Vaucheria belong to oomycetes of fungi because of cinocytic acellular organization of thallus, their cell wall composition, and oogamous type of sexual reproduction. These features resemble Vaucheria to this group oomycetes. We are studying this Vaucheria in algae, and the most accepted classification is Lee. Therefore, for this particular lecture, we will believe that Vaucheria belong to Gentophyceae. And before starting Vaucheria, just have a quick revision of major characteristic feature of this class Gentophyceae. Okay, Gentophyceae
are mostly found in freshwater.
Okay.
And few are marine.
Few are marine means they are basically freshwater in nature, but there are some species or some genus which you can also found in marine system.
Okay.
They are either non-motile unicellular or colonial eukaryotic algae. They are most closely related to Phaeophyceae or brown algae. And their pigment also shows that they have chlorophyll A, C, E along with beta carotene and xanthophyll. And that's why they are also known as yellow green algae or yellow brown algae. So this yellow green color and the intensity of yellow color or green color, it depends if chlorophyll jada hai ya xanthophyll jada hai or beta carotene jada hai. The painter blend karta na different colors ko to get a particular shade of color. The same way the actual color of algae is depend upon the amount of available chlorophyll, beta carotene or xanthophyll. So the overall amount of these pigments will give its final color. But more or less, they are yellow-green algae. Pyrenoids usually absent. Reserve food material. This time, you will see the very first genus after Chlorophyceae that they don't have starch as their reserve food material. इसीलिए हम उसको किसे stain नहीं करेंगे?
Iodine.
Iodine से stain नहीं करेंगे.
Iodine.
Cell wall. Yeah, thank you, dear. So, cell wall are rich of pectin and usually made up of cellulose. Flagella present, but not in the actual thallus. When they are present, अगर हम flagella present की बात कर रहे हैं, तो आप ये नहीं बोलेंगे कि सर उमाशिटी में तो हमें sorry वाउचीरिया में तो हमें flagella नहीं दिखा. No. Any time in during their life cycle, if flagella present, then we will say that they are flagella are present. Reproduction, whatever you can assume, the same thing you can find in different genus of this particular class, whether it is vegetative, asexual or sexual. There are many order, amongst them Vaucheria belong to Vaucherian order, and this order have only one family Vaucheriaceae and single genus Vaucheria, and that is Plamenta sinocytic. Siphonous organization and sexual reproduction oogamous. Because of these three features, you can say that this particular genus belongs to Vaucheria or Vaucherius or Vaucherius. Vaucheria introduction. So, the very first thing, how this genus got its name? This genus got its name after Jean Pierre Etienne Vaucher. The maximum siphonosis means you will not find septate or cell wall formation throughout the thallus until unless it's not an injury or it's not a site of reproductive sex organ. There you will not find any kind of cell wall formation. And this is the, you can say, this is the climax of siphonous habit. Vaucheria, along with these three genus, Vaucheriopsis, dichotomosiphon, and pseudodichotomosiphon, what position in family Vaucheriaceae, order siphonates of the class Chlorophyceae. Or that's why Fritz also placed this genus under these taxon. Lekin uske baad, we found that there is no chlorophyll B. It contains chlorophyll E. It contains excess of carotenoid over chlorophyll, storage food, not start its oil, and unequal length of paired flagella. That's why Lee placed it under Xanthophyceae. This Xanthophyceae is more closer to Pheophyceae, because वहीं पे हमारे heterocone type flagella मिलते हैं. Phylum ही change कर दिया. Vaucheria is the lone genus in the lone family of Vaucheriaceae. अगर हम इसके occurrence की बात करें तो अभी तक हमने जितने भी green algae पढ़े थे, they were slow running water, they are usually underwater algae. But you can say this particular genus is amphibian. Amphibian. Amphibian का मतलब जानते हो? Amphibious का मतलब क्या होता है?
Both terrestrial and aquatic?
Yes, terrestrial and aquatic. But if terrestrial नहीं बोलेंगे, आप इसको ये बोलेंगे, it needs certain exposure of air. Means, so that's why you will find Vaucheria in muddy area, or you will find the stagnant water, or you will find the where the water level keep on coming up and down, so that those position or those area where sometime it that area remain underwater and sometime it get exposed to air. If you will not provide air to this genus, it will not survive. Just have a quick revision ke hum kaise isko slides banate hain lab mein. So this is the material we have in our lab. I have said so many times that please try to take a very small amount of material. And very, and because it's very delicate, it's tube-like structure. So when you are separating out this filamentous structure, you should be very careful. If you will forcefully try to separate it, it will get breakdown. Why we are using safranin this time? Bataiye.
Because it doesn't have starch, so because we don't use it.
Yes. Take another slide. This is glycine. The role of glycine. Jo use karte glycine.
Mounting medium.
Yes, mounting. For staining we will use safranin, and for mounting we will use glycerin. And very gently, don't try to forcefully separate out the filament structure. This is the material, and then you will cover it with cover slip. Again, the same way, hold the cover slip in 45 degree and then gently cover the material by removing the needle so that the entire material will get covered under cover slip without any air bubble. So let's discuss the thallus morphology. So this is the overall structure of thallus, or the how you will observe it under the microscope. You can see that the entire body is tubular shape, yellowish green, cylindrical, and filamentous as well as branch. You can see the branching is also arising from this area. And this branching is not any having any particular pattern. It is irregular shape. If you will see the entire intact thallus, you will also find the rhizoid-like structure. Okay, so that it can absorb the nutrient and water. Okay, and uske baad whatever you will see is you will see this tube like structure in continuity. If you will see the detail of this, the diagrammatic representation of the apical portion, you will see that it is having two systems, one the vacuole part and outermost is your cell wall and plasma membrane. And in between the vacuole part and the plasma membrane, entire cytoplasm will you will see like this. And there is no wall formation. Aap kahin pe bhi isme wall formation nahi dekhenge. Can you see it's a continuous structure?
Yes, sir.
Fat or lipid body, you can also see this. Okay. Is it visible to everyone? Is it?
Yes, sir.
And this is because of?
Yes, sir.
It's a storage material. And this cytoplasm contains many nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, and apical portion, you will see more vesicle compared to other. So everything you will find is suspended in this continuous cytoplasm. The thallus is composed of yellow-green cylindrical tubular but coarse filament. Thallus consists of colorless basal rhizoids. Growth of the filament is restricted to apex, which has a large number of vesicles that I just show you. Apne jo apical portion dekha usme compared to the rest of the part, apical part mein aapko vesicles zyada dikhai denge compared to any other part. And I will also explain the reason behind this. Why there are more vesicles when we will discuss the reproduction. And the rest of the cytoplasmic material like chloroplast, nuclei, central dictyosome, mitochondria, everything remains suspended. इसके अलावा बाकी फीचर्स हैं अगर दो डिटेल जाएंगे देन इट हैज रिलेटिवली थिन सेल वॉल. सेल वॉल डिवाइड इनटू इनर लेयर ऑफ द सेलुलोज एंड द आउटर लेयर ऑफ पैक्टिक सब्सटेंस. ए लार्ज वैक्यूल मींस वैक्यूल इज आल्सो इन कंटिन्यूटी बट इट्स रिमेन. जस्ट इमेजिन इट्स लाइक ए ट्यूबुलर स्ट्रक्चर. इट्स जस्ट लाइक दिस. देयर इज वन लार्ज ट्यूब एंड इनसाइड दिस देयर इज वन स्मॉल ट्यूब. So this tube is the vacuole region, a very large central vacuole. And outside this, you will find everything suspended that we have already discussed. Pionoids, if you will go the ultra structure, you will not find pionoids in chromatophores. We have shown you that the reserve food is oil or fat. ये बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट है. वाउचीरिया साइटोकाइनेसिस इज नॉट यूजुअली फॉलोड बाय माइटोसिस. न्यूक्लियर तो डिवाइड होंगे बार 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 बट देयर विल बी नो सेप्टा फॉर्मेशन विल टेक प्लेस. दैट्स व्हाई दिस कंडीशन इज नोन एज सिनोसिटिक मल्टी न्यूक्लिएट एसेप्टेट कंडीशन. प्लीज नोट इट डाउन. सिनोसिटिक मीन्स मल्टी न्यूक्लिएट एसेप्टेट. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज ए सेलुलर सिनोसिटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म rather than calling it a multicellular form. Just imagine it's a tube-like structure and it is filled of watery body of watery cytoplasm which has some suspended chloroplast and other things. Just imagine if you will puncture it from here, it may possible that it is having very thin cell wall. So this cell wall or infectious substance may get breakdown. ऐसा हो सकता है ना यहाँ से break हो जाए.
Yes sir.
It's just imagine कि आपने एक polythene ली है जो आप बाजार से लेके आए हैं and you fill it with water and if you will carry it unconsciously, it is possible that if कोई आके उसमें किसी चीज से टकरा कर या because of the pressure of the water or because of any other physical things, it may get puncture. और जैसे ही उस polythene में puncture होगा तो क्या होगा?
The liquid will flow out.
Liquid will flow out. So to protect the then cytoplasm to leach out from the thallus during any physical injury, they always make ए सेप्टा. मीन्स अगर कोई भी चाहे वो सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन का टाइम हो, ज्यूस्पोर फॉर्मेशन हो, एपेनोस्पोर फॉर्मेशन हो, फिजिकल इंजरी हो, एनी काइंड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन हो, यू विल ऑल्सो सी द सेप्टा फॉर्मेशन. और उसे क्या कर देगा? दे विल सेपरेट आउट दैट पोर्सन विच इज नॉट परफॉर्मिंग द यूजुअल थिंग्स. बाकी साइटोप्लाज्म नॉर्मल थैलस क्या करता है? इट गो फॉर द normal metabolic activity like respiration, photosynthesis and other things. But if there is an injury, if there is an infection, if there is any process or requirement of the reproduction, they will try to separate out that portion from the rest of the thallus. In case of such an emergency, septum is formed to localize the injured part and to save the rest of the filament. Suppose this is a balloon full of water. If you will puncture it, everything will come out. But if you have a balloon like this, full of water, but you have separate out this portion. So if you will puncture it, so this part will remain protected. This part will be punctured or it will release its content. So septa formation nature mein aap dekhiye ki itna delicate sa organism banaya hai aur इसकी खासियत ये है कि देयर इज नो सेल वॉल फॉर्मेशन बट इन केस ऑफ इमरजेंसी इट कैन फॉर्म द सेप्टा और सेल वॉल. साइटोप्लाज्मिक स्ट्रीमिंग टेक्स प्लेस इन द एरिया ऑफ लार्ज सेंट्रल वैक्यूल एंड डायरेक्टली इन्वॉल्व द न्यूक्लियाई माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड अदर देयर एसोसिएटेड डिक्टियोसोम. अब ऑल दोज फोटोग्राफ व्हिच आई हैव शोन इन यू इन दिस स्लाइड they are either taken from the internet or from some research article. But here you will see how you will observe it in lab. Can you see it? It's just like a tube, like thin polythene like structure which has some something inside it. All these are the cellular content. Can you see it? Also focus it. It's Eugonia. We will discuss about it later on. It's in high power. You are observing that most of the things have nothing inside it. As well as there's a khali polythene only. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me why it is so? Just, yeah. I stop it over here because this is the only site where we can see Eugonia and Antheridia. Otherwise, we have seen permanent slides and photographs. But what I want to discuss over here, you can see this part is showing something inside it. But this part is not having anything. This part is not having anything. Okay. And you will also see many other parts like this. Somewhere it's full of cytoplasm. Somewhere it is, there's nothing. Why it is so? You can see this part is completely empty. This part is completely empty. This part is completely full. This part is completely empty. This is also empty. This is full. Why it is happening? Aisa kyun ho raha hai? बहुत कॉमन सेंस का आंसर है बताइए
सर बिकॉज ऑफ द डैमेज
यस जब हमने इसको कलेक्ट किया यस व्हेन वी कलेक्टेड इट एंड फिक्स इट सो उसके बाद इट बिकम डेड एंड दैट डेड बॉडी कैन नॉट फॉर्म द सेल वॉल फॉर्मेशन सो व्हेन वेयर एवर इज देयर एनी फिजिकल इंजरी द एंटायर कंटेंट ऑफ द थैलस लीच आउट इसलिए से कई जगह से वो कंप्लीट ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर भी नहीं दिख रही है आपको बहुत थिन सी लाइन दिख रही है जैसे पंचर होकर सब कुछ निकल चुका हो इसमें से सो दिस वाज अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजी मॉर्फोलॉजी में कोई डाउट है तो आप पूछ सकते हैं
सर ये तो पर इमरजेंसी के टाइम पे सब तो बना लेते हैं तो फिर कैसे सब बाहर
इमरजेंसी के टाइम पे आयशा अगर आप किसी जागते हुए इंसान को या होश में जो इंसान उसको थप्पड़ मारोगे वो अपने आप को प्रोटेक्ट करेगा या नहीं करेगा अगर आप सामने वाले को लड़ोगे और उसको कोई फिजिकल हार्म पहुंचाना चाहोगे हाथों से या किसी हथियार से वेदर ही और सी विल प्रोटेक्ट हिमसेल्फ और नॉट
यस
लेकिन अगर आप किसी सोते हुए इंसान को या मरे हुए इंसान को करोगे तो That's the answer. If algae is live, they will try to protect themselves by making the cell wall formation. It totally depends ki kis intensity ka usme infection ya physical injury aayegi. Live material mein se bhi leach out ho sakta hai if it is a drastic injury to them. It's the physical injury agar koi bahut halki minute physical injury ho rahi hai aur infection ho raha hai because by some other fungus or bacteria, they will try to protect them. But if it's a intensive attack from a pathogen or foreign organism, then it will not be possible for Vaucheria or any other organism to protect themselves. चलिए अब हम बात करते हैं reproduction की. Vaucheria एक ऐसा genus है जहां पर लगभग आपने जितने भी type of reproduction पढ़े हैं, you will divide it over here. Whatever you can imagine. Number one, vegetative reproduction. So it may possible then if you will divide the Vaucheria in different fragment, each and every fragment is capable to develop into a new thallus, depending upon the length of the thallus. बहुत छोटा part होगा तो नहीं survive कर पाएगा, but if it is having sufficient amount length of thallus, it will survive. ए सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है और इंटरेस्टिंग. बिफोर टेलिंग यू अबाउट द ए सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, लेट डिस्कस वेन एंड वेयर इट इज ए रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ ड्रिस्पोर्ट. अगर लाइट की कमी हो, लो लाइट और कंप्लीट डार्कनेस, अगर जो रनिंग वाटर एकदम से स्टिल वाटर हो जाए, और वीक कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट इन द कल्चर मीडियम. इफ यू आर कल्चरिंग द वाउचेरिया, दैट इज द टाइम वेन इट विल ट्राई टू डेवलप ज्यूस्पोर. उसका ज्यूस्पोर बड़ा स्पेशल होता है. एट द एपिकल पोर्शन ऑफ द एनी ट्यूबुलर पार्ट और एनी ट्यूबुलर ब्रांच, टॉप मोस्ट पोर्शन गेट सेपरेट आउट फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द थैलस. कैन यू सी दिस पोर्शन?
यस सर.
So, this structure will become zoosporangia, which develop always at the end of the side branch. And within this zoosporangia, this entire content will get aggregated inside a ovular shape. And because now the instead of carotenoids or xanthophyll, chlorophyll become more prominent, that's why it's become more green compared to the rest of the thallus. The norm, unlike the normal thallus where you will see the nuclei, chromatophores are suspended, you will see there is a slight arrangement. Nucleus you will see towards periphery. Agar isko aap cut karke dekhenge, then you will see that towards its periphery, its nucleus, and toward this vacuole you will see chromatophores. You remember this, there was vesicle also present, numerous vesicle also present at the tip portion?
Yes sir.
So same yes, sir. Way ab aapko kya hoga jab aap yahan pe jayenge, you will also see these vesicles. This sporangium start appearing deep green due to the diminishing of vacuole nuclei in the young Jewish sporangium come to the external, that I have already discussed. ये ध्यान रखना, ए पेयर ऑफ सेंट्रियोल इज एसोसिएटेड विद ईच ऑफ द न्यूमरस न्यूक्लियाई आर प्रोड्यूस थ्रू द वेसिकल मेम्ब्रेन. ये जो फ्लैजेला आपके निकले हैं ना, ये ऑल दीज फ्लैजेला, यू न्यू दैट दिस पोर्शन वाज रिच ऑफ वेसिकल, एंड फ्रॉम दीज वेसिकल मेम्ब्रेन यू विल सी द एमर्जेंस ऑफ फ्लैजेला. तो वेसिकल भी पेरिफेरी के टुवर्ड्स जाएंगे, न्यूक्लियस भी पेरिफेरी के टुवर्ड्स जाएगा, बट chromatophores will be towards the vacuole. And this entire structure will come out through a small pore or aperture. And you can see that all those things are attached together. They are not single nucleate. They are multi-nucleate structure still. Even in zoospore condition. So they are coming out as thin zoospore. Please note down this time. Thin zoospore. So thin zoospores are the zoospores of Vaucheria, which are multi-flagellate, multi-nucleate, but aseptic structures take place, originate from the zoosporangium, which originate at the tip part. After separating out the tip portion from the rest of the thallus, nuclei and vesicles comes towards the periphery, chromatophores will towards central vacuoles, and from the vesicle membrane they originate the flagella. What kind of flagella you will observe over here? Flagella kaise hote hain inke?
Heterocone type.
Heterocone type. Heterocone means they are not only differ in size, but also they are differ in their surface. One of them will be whiplash type, another is of tinsel type. This zoospore will then get liberated out. Zoospore hai side mein aapke jo hai nuclei hai, vesicles hai, in vesicle ki membrane se flagella nikla up towards periphery nuclei hai, towards center ki taraf aapke chromatophores hai. That's why after some time when it will get sufficient nutrient or the environmental condition is suitable for this, as usual, सबसे पहले ये क्या काम करेंगे, अपने फ्लैजेला को छोड़ देंगे. फ्लैजेला काम के लिए इतना होता है It will allow the movement of the juice spore or any other motile structure until unless they are not reaching to that point when there is no, their environmental condition is suitable for them. Germination bilkul ho sakta hai, ek taraf bhi ho sakta hai, do taraf bhi ho sakta hai. Like this drawing is showing the germination of juice spore in two directions. It may be one or two or sometimes even three directions as well. यहाँ पे आपको एक बड़ी सुंदर सी वीडियो मुझको मिली है फर्स्ट टाइम, सो आई एम जस्ट शोइंग यू हाउ इट विल गेट लिबरेटेड आउट. इट्स स्पिनिंग रिलीज ऑफ द जेंट मल्टी न्यूक्लेटेड मल्टी फ्लैजिलेटेड जू स्पोर. दिस इज द वे यू विल कलेक्ट इट. This is the way it will get formed inside it. And it is the released juice spore. Now, this is the best thing of this video. It is around 50 times, means the speed of karai 50 guna tez bada ke dikhaiye, then you will see ke how it is coming out from the main thallus. This is the actual speed.
Sir, ye kis tarah karte shoot inko videos mein se?
वीडियो को शूट जब माइक्रोस्कोपी पढ़ाऊंगा ना बच्चे, या किसी और दिन जब माइक्रोस्कोपी, देयर आर सर्टेन माइक्रोस्कोप वेयर वी कैन यूज द लाइव मटेरियल. इवन अगर हमारे अगर सपोज कीजिए यू हैव कलेक्टेड एनी मटेरियल ड्यूरिंग दिस फेज व्हेन इट इज अबाउट टू कम एंड यू ऑटोमेटिकली स्टार्ट ऑब्जर्विंग अंडर द माइक्रोस्कोप, तो आप देख सकते हो, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. पेज कंट्रास्ट ही होता है सर मेनली तो इस तरह की चीजों के लिए. जैसे हमें जो जो भी चीज हमें लाइव देखनी है उसके लिए सबसे अच्छा है फेज कंट्रास्ट माइक्रोस्कोप, बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव टू यूज एनी काइंड ऑफ स्टेन ओवर देयर. बट इसके अलावा भी और भी टेक्निक्स है इसकी, जैसे PIV कोई एनालिसिस है, मुझे नहीं पता वो क्या है. यू कैन सी फ्लैजेला किस तरह से आपको यहाँ पे हल्का सा इमेजिन कर सकते हो, बाकी डिटेल के लिए तो आपको फिक्स करना पड़ेगा इस मटेरियल को उसके साथ फॉर ट्रांसमिशन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप और स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. तो थैंक्स टू दीज ऑथर जिन्होंने इतना अच्छा सा वीडियो बनाया. तो हैव यू सीन दिस वीडियो, तो अब आपको हमेशा याद रहेगा कि व्हाई इट इज नोन एज जू स्पोर, बिकॉज इट हैव मल्टीपल फ्लैजेला. Flagella originate from the vesicle surface, and but it is a small structure, circular or oval shaped structures, and with the help of that flagella, it will remain in the motile condition. अब बात करते हैं एफ्लेनोस्पोर की. सब कुछ बिल्कुल ठीक है, मैं कुछ भी राइट टेक्स्ट लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है यहाँ पे. Everything is same. Efflenospore एनजीएम will develop in the same manner. Aplanospore will come out in the same manner. The only difference is, क्या difference है बताओ? Aplanospore में, juice spore में?
Sir, Aplanospore non-flagellated, non-motile होता है.
बस यही है. बिल्कुल. तो जब आपने पहली बार ये चीज पढ़ी होगी juice spore और Aplanospore, तो आपको याद नहीं रहा होगा. लेकिन अब जैसे ही Aplanospore नाम आता है ऑटोमेटिकली आपके माइंड में एक आ जाता है कि ठीक है ये नॉन मोटाइल है, जूस पोर ये मोटाइल है, एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर ऑलमोस्ट सेम. पता नहीं, जरूरत नहीं है कि टर्मिनल पार्ट पे होता है, थिन वाल भी होते हैं ये भी. इसमें क्या लाइक बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग सी चीज है कि द रेट ऑफ जर्मिनेशन टू आर स्पीड विल बी 266 माइक्रोमीटर पर आर, देन इट विल गो स्लो डाउन 96 माइक्रोमीटर पर आर, एंड देन इट विल अगेन रीच अप टू 168 माइक्रोमीटर पर आर. नेक्स्ट इज एकाइनेट्स. एकाइनेट्स आफ्टर जूस्पोर एफ्लेनोस्पोर देयर इज वन मोर टाइप ऑफ एसेक्सुअल स्पोर. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट स्पोर?
ऑटोस्पोर.
नहीं, ऑटोस्पोर्स में नहीं बनेगी, हाइपनोस्पोर. and hypnospore ko yaad rakhega, I am resembling it with almost a different thing. Their motto is same. Jo hypnospore banne ka jo motto hota hai, wahi aapka endospore banne ka motto hota hai. That they want to survive in extreme condition. Zoospore, apnospore will develop in a normal condition. But suppose ki ye talab hai, talab mein kya hua, pani ki lagatar kami hoti ja rahi hai, concentration salt ka badhta ja raha hai. So what they will do? They will try to protect their cell content in a very protective layer. And that layer will be a very thick membrane or wall. And if a spore, if a sexual spore having an extremely thick wall, that is known as hypnospore. But they arise in the chain. That's why it is known as echinid. If someone is asking hypnospore of Vaucheria or echinids of Vaucheria, meaning that is same for both the things. Individually, they are known as the hypnospore, and the entire structure is known as echinids. As I told you, extreme desiccant, bahut bilkul pani nahi hai, bahut low temperature ho gaya, then they will produce this kind of spore. Jo branch hai, puri ki puri row ban jayegi is tarah ke spores ki. Inko hum cyst bhi bol sakte hain, hypnospore bhi bol sakte hain, aur echinids bhi bol sakte hain. But bada interesting sa hai term, please yaad rakhiyega isko. Gonorrhea stage. It's a very common question will come. Write a short note on gonorrhea stage. It means they want to know about the hypnospore or echinids or cyst of Vaucheria. Gonorrhea is a different algae. Aap Google mein search karenge to aapko gonorrhea ek algae hai, green algae hai, which look like this structure. It's nothing to do with the gonorrhea. Well, appearance वैसा दिखता है, इसको हम बोलते हैं gonorrhea stage.
Yes sir.
अब search करेंगे, the rest of the things are same, it will get liberated out and will germinate. ठीक है ना? जैसे until unless there is no favorable condition, जैसे favorable condition return होंगे, these cells, these hypnospore, these echinids will germinate either into new filament or sometimes the protoplast of the echinid divide into small protoplasmic pieces and then it will develop. This was all about the asexual reproduction. Bataiye koi doubt hai to?
No sir.
Okay. So let's discuss the sexual reproduction. As you know that this is the genus, you will see the diplontic type of life cycle. And the only haploid structure are the gametes. Most of the species are homothallic or monoecious. It means
both the sex organs are present in same plant.
Yes. Same thallus bola karo bachche algae ke case mein. Kuch hai jo dioecious hai like Vaucheria dichotoma and Vaucheria littoria. So dioecious hai jahan pe you will see that either Ugonia or Antheridia. Ogamous type pe to automatically Ugonia or Antheridium ke size alag alag hi hoga. Yeah, this point is important. In the monoecious or the homothallic species, the two sex organ usually occur close to one another at intervals along the same filament, arising as a lateral outgrowth. ठीक है, sessile type. और दूसरा है आपका species like the sex organ develop on a special side branch, gameta type. Okay, gameta type का क्या होता है? I will show you in the next figure. दो तरह के हो सकते हैं, या तो normal तरीके से grow हो रहे हैं thallus के ऊपर as usual, या फिर there is a small branch and on that branch they are arising. उस branch में भी क्या है? The side branch consists of a pedicel, either with a terminal antheridium, या तो term antheridium होगा, and a number of lateral ugonia, or a terminal ugonia with an antheridium located laterally. This is homothallic sessile type. यानी कि आपका क्या ये मेन थैलस था And on the main thallus, there is a septa formation and there is the origin of Hugonia or Antheridia. Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
And
yes,
here,
sir.
You will see homothallic gametinata type. What does it mean? That from the main thallus, there is a pedicel-like structure. And on this branch, there is a development of sex organ. Origin is two ways. Either terminal it is antheridia and it is surrounded by Hugonia. Yeah, the beach make male and baki chantra female. Or it is having a terminal Hugonia and a lateral antheridia. Antheridia ek hi hoga, dono hi case mein. Okay? Sessile ka matlab aapko pata hi hai ki jahan pe matlab, although aap bologe sir sessile hai choti si branch to dikhe, but no, we are not discussing about this branch. We are discussing a very prominent branch. That's why this is known as gaminata type. Or isko hum sessile bolte. Then these are the two photographs of heterothallic antheridia and Hugonia of Vaucheria dichotoma. Ab hum antheridium ki baat karte hain detail mein. Cylindrical, slender or tubular structure, generally a horn-like. Jaise kuch mein ye colorless bhi ho sakta hai, otherwise ye green hota hai. Colorless kyun hota hai? Jahan pe chlorophyll hai, wo kam amount mein ho. Usually ye placed high hota hai, like jo maine aapko second wala dikhaya hai. The terminal is single Hugonia and a laterally placed single antheridia. It's very rare. Hamesha hi jata terminal pe hi hoga. Mature antheridium has that spermatozoa produced in a specific area between the central and the peripheral cytoplasm. Ye koi unusual cheez nahi, kuch bhi development hota hai usme. Wo central vacuole aur bahar ki jo peripheral membrane hai unke beech mein hoga. Because the cell content is only there. उस बीच में ही तो है सेंट्रल वैक्यूल के और बाहर की पेरिफेरी के बीच में. दिस इज इंपोर्टेंट द स्मॉल लिब्रेटेड गैमेट और स्पर्म इज एन ओवल स्पिंडल और पियर शेप एंड कलरलेस स्ट्रक्चर विद टू लेटरली इंसर्टेड एंड अपोजिट फ्लैजेला ऑफ अनइक्वल लेंथ. द शॉर्ट वन पॉइंट टुवर्ड्स फॉरवर्ड एंड द लॉन्ग वन पॉइंट बैकवर्ड. तो इसीलिए ये हाइड्रोकोन टाइप भी होते हैं, वे प्लेसेंट टेंसर टाइप के. So this is antheridia, horn-shaped structure in between the central vacuole and the periphery. Antheridia, they will come out from the small structure and the individual sperm or spermatozoids are having two unequal size heterocone type flagella. Agar hum Hugonia ki baat karte hain, so very prominent, sessile or aapko pata hai shayad sessile ho sakti hai, side branch pe bhi develop ho sakti hai. And they get separated out from the filament by the cross wall. Initially it is multinuclear, but all the nuclei except one migrate out from the differentiated Hugonium into the subtending filament. Then beech mein bahut bada sa nucleus hai, jaise aapko yahan pe dikh jayega. You can see the big nucleus over here. Dikh raha hai na aapko? Black structure, this one. Ye mature hai. और दूसरी चीज इसकी ये बीक मीन्स व्हेन इट गेट मैच्योर इट विल मेक ए बीक एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द कंटेंट विल बी स्लाइटली टुवर्ड्स द मेन फिलामेंट साइड. यहां पे देखेंगे आप ये बीक जरूर बनाएगा ये ठीक. एंड द बाकी थोड़ा सा जितना भी हमारा कंटेंट है इट विल बी शिफ्टेड टुवर्ड्स द अदर साइड फ्रॉम दिस बीक और टुवर्ड्स द मेन फिलामेंट. लिजर्ड फूड ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट्स है. इट्स वेरी रेयर दैट द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस Hugonia विल कम आउट. दैट्स व्हाई आपने देखा होगा, हमने पहले वाली स्लाइड हम देख रहे थे जो लैब में बनाई थी. तो दिस स्ट्रक्चर वॉज वेरी प्रोमिनेंट. ये तो क्या इंटरनेट फोटोग्राफ से आपको दोबारा से दिखाऊंगा तो आप देखेंगे. बाकी सारे कंटेंट लीच आउट हो सकता है लेकिन इसका कंटेंट आसान से लीच आउट नहीं होता है. Now fertilization and germination. The antheridia and Hugonia may dehisce same time or from the few minutes to difference. जब वे fully mature हो जाते हैं तो ये जो beak है इसका beak और antheridium का अपर्चर से जो male sperm निकलते हैं, both the event will occur simultaneously. अगर थोड़ा difference होगा तो it will not be more than to R. At the tip of oogonia, a pore or apical aperture is formed. Several sperm emitted from the apical pore in the wall of antidium gather around it. ये जो पोर है जो बीक है उसके अराउंड आ जाएंगे वे एंड देन ड्यूरिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन सेवरल स्पर्मेटोजोइट्स और मेल स्पर्म एंटर द ओगोनिया थ्रू द अपर्चर फॉर्म्ड एट द बीक जो बीक बनाई थी जो उसके अंदर होल है उसके थ्रू वे एंटर करेंगे टू गेट फर्टिलाइज विद देमसेल्फ विद द एग सेल एंड द मेल एंड फीमेल न्यूक्लियस डू नॉट फ्यूज इमीडिएटली The small male nucleus lies near the female nucleus and increase in size until it has swollen to nearly the same volume before it fused with the female nucleus. Background se noise aa rahi hogi, please uske liye mujhe maaf kijiyega. Male and female nuclei dono pass aa jayenge, but they will not fuse immediately. This male nucleus will start absorbing the nutrient from the nearby area or from the egg cell, and once they are the sufficient size or the same size for the nucleus, then they will get fused and to form zygote. After fertilization, the aperture of oogonium is plugged. Suppose this is the bee and there was a hole. Once one male sperm entered inside this, it will remain here around this periphery. Will get swollen up, but the moment it gets fertilized with the egg cell, ye entry band ho jayegi, so that no more male sperm will come inside the oogonium. And the zygote develops a zygospore after secreting several layer thick wall around itself. When the original wall gets decayed, the zygospore gets liberated. It then undergoes a period of rest, the chloroplast disappears. ये आप देखेंगे जब फर्टिलाइज हो चुका है तो क्लोरोप्लास्ट नहीं है एंड इट विल मेक अस लाइक हाइपोस्पोर मल्टी लेयर स्ट्रक्चर एंड व्हेन दिस विल डेमिनिश जब बाहर की जो ओगोनियल वॉल है व्हेन इट विल गेट बस्ट आउट व्हेन इट विल गेट डिके देन इट विल गेट एक्सपोर्ट टुवर्ड द एनवायरमेंट और तब ये आएगा दीज आर द स्लाइड विच वी हैव मेड इन अवर लैब ये ओगोनिया है एंथीडियस ये नहीं दिखता क्योंकि देयर आर चांसेस दैट Their content has been leached out. This is one or more structure. Okay, here you can see the beak is very prominent over here. Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, ye beak ki main part. Yeah, this is also the diagram from our permanent slides. Okay, you can see the beak is there. So, jaise hi descent hote hai, ye beak bhi open hoti hai, and it will attract the male gamete. And the male gamete will enter inside this hole and it will remain over here, will get nutrient, will become the same size and get fertilized itself with this. This is also one photograph taken from the internet, algae base, you can see. And this is the fertilized egg cell. This is the last important point. Without formation of meiospores, Without formation of meiospore, after the dormant period, the zygospore germinates. अगर meiospore नहीं बना रहे हैं, इसका मतलब the zygote will directly germinate in diploid condition, and that's why the life cycle will be of किस तरह की life cycle होगी फिर?
Diploid.
Lab में हमने कैसे किया है आप ये देख सकते हैं. This is the oogonia. These are the from the temporary slides. Earlier we were focusing on these tube-like structure, but this time we will focus only on oogonia. You are supposed to show this structure to the examiner if you are performing. Yes, you can see the beak over here. Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
नेचुरल कंडीशन में आपको ऐसे दिखाई देगा आपको अच्छे अच्छे फोटोग्राफ नहीं दिखाई देंगे माइक्रोस्कोप के अंदर यू हैव टू फाइंड इट आउट जस्ट हैव ए लुक इट्स फुल ऑफ ऑयल सो दैट इट कैन नरिश द मेल स्पर्म इवन बिफोर द फर्टिलाइजेशन ये हमारी परमानेंट स्लाइड से यहाँ पे वी हैव वाउचेरिया सेक्सुअल होल माउंड लेट्स सी कि हमने कौन से फिक्स किए. यस बताइए ये कौन सा टाइप है. होमोथैलिक, हेट्रोथैलिक, होमोथैलिक सेसाइल, होमोथैलिक गेमेंटा सकते इसको. There are four oogonia and on the top there is an antheridia. Homothallic gamenta type. This is the photograph during the fertilization, how they are getting fertilized with each other. We are showing all these photographs just to give you the actual exposure. Okay, how you have to identify it. Internet photographs se वैसे नहीं दिखाई देगा आपको. So this is the one photograph where you can see the egg cells and oogonia and antheridia. This is one more structure. This is one more. This is young one. Are the young antheridia and oogonia. So this is all about the these structures. See, in 40x, sometimes it's not possible to locate it. So we have to come back again and again up to 10x so that we can bring this structure in the center. I was trying to bring this structure in the center so that we can show you at 40x. Now it's on 40x. Have a better view. So that's it about the Vaucheria.
Sir, मैं ये पूछ रहा था जैसे Vaucheria की systematic position is little bit complicated. So is it for only Vaucheria or with the other members of the group like Vaucheriaceae?
Sir, Vaucheriaceae में तो एक ही है ना, lone genus है. Vaucheria, Vaucheriopsis, Dictyosiphon and Pseudodictyotomosiphon were the position in the family Vaucheriaceae under order Siphonales of class Chlorophyceae. Vaucheria ko in teen alag genus ke saath Chlorophyceae mein rakha fridge mein. Lekin Lee ne kya kiya hai isme, but for Vaucheria especially, they found out that they neither have chlorophyll B, nor have the isocon type of flagella, nor they are having the dominant chlorophyll. That's why they make it altogether different order, Vaucherias, Vaucheriaceae and Vaucheria. Means, us order mein keval ek hi family aur ek hi genus hai, sir.
Okay, okay. All right. So one more thing. What is your opinion about Vaucheria, that where should it be placed?
It totally depends के आज की डेट में most accepted क्या है. अगर कल को ली से अच्छा कोई classification आ जाता है, then we will try कि ठीक है, हाँ ली की में कुछ कमियां थी, now that had been rectified and now the best position is either chlorophyceae or gentophyceae or somewhere else. हो सकता है कि नया classification आए, वो Vaucheria को algae में ही ना रखे. As some of the mycologists are claiming that the Vaucheria don't belong to algae at all. Because it has the sinocytic condition, it has the pectic substance in the cell wall, then why you are putting it in the algae? Only just because it's having the chlorophyll. Ho sakta kuch adaptation ho mycetes ka. So very, very dramatic things is there, but the beauty is understanding this taxonomic question. The more knowledge, more confusion.
One more thing, sir. Is there classification based on molecular data also? And what does it say?
ये बता तो रहा है सर, ये जो इसका है ली का क्लासिफिकेशन है, इट इज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडिंग द मोलिकुलर डाटा एंड इट सेज दैट इट बिलोंग टू जेंथोफाइसी. अगर मोलिकुलर डाटा नहीं भी होता तो भी ली इसको उसमें ही प्लेस करता. 16 ऐसा और 18 ऐसा आरएनए के ऊपर जो इन्होंने क्लासिफाइड किया है, ली ऑल्सो कंसिडर दैट बट नॉट द सोल. मीन्स ऐसा नहीं है कि उसने 16 और 18 के ऊपर ही कर दिया है. He considered that as a part of the classification, not the entire basis of the classification. So this is the life cycle. अगर आप ली की बुक पढ़ेंगे तो आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा इट्स ए डिप्लॉयड लाइफ साइकिल. और ये लाइफ साइकिल है पूरी, इसमें कहते रहा है कि दिस पार्ट इज शोइंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ जूस स्पोर, लिबरेशन ऑफ जूस स्पोर, जिन जूस स्पोर, जर्मिनेशन ऑफ जिन जूस स्पोर, formation of Vaucheria tetra. Then the next line is afflenoid spore and the next line is for echinoid spore. Okay. Whereas the bottom part is showing the sexual reproduction.
Sir, diagram, sir.
I was waiting for this question. Next. Ye classification proposed by Levy distribution kuch hai hi nahi isme, kyunki gentophyte hum discuss kar chuke hain detail mein. Heteroconchophyta mein kyun hai? Because it's having the tripartite hair, anterior flagellum, posterior whiplash flagellum, chlorophyll A and C, fucogen thin, storage product oils. Gentophyceae mein kyun rakha hua hai? Ye bhi bata diya humne. And we have already discussed, because of its filamentous sinusitic condition, we have kept it under Vaucheria. Under single family Vaucheria and single genus Vaucheria. ये है आपके डायग्राम. एंड यू शुड से थैंक्स टू मिनाल भार्गव मैम, वन ऑफ द रिटायर्ड प्रोफेसर ऑफ आवर डिपार्टमेंट. सो दिस इज द Vaucheria, वेरी सिंपल डायग्राम. दिस इज द ओनली थिंग यू हैव टू शो. एक सिंपल सा फिलामेंट है विच इज शोइंग द ब्रांचिंग पैटर्न एंड वी कैन ओनली सी द क्रोमेटोफोर्स और ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट एंड द साइटोप्लाज्म. वी कैन एज्यूम द थिंग्स विच आर गेटिंग एनी स्टेन इज साइटोप्लाज्म and the boundary are cell wall and the entire structure is a filament. But a simple structure you have banana. The next is young sex organ. It's up to you whether you want to make it or not. The third diagram you will make homothelic sessile type sex organ. Feel that the photograph the shown in the video is slightly different than this, then go for that. I'm just giving you a hint. In the gametogen type sex organ, you will show it over here. Because antheridia was not clearly visible over there, so there is no need to make the antheridia here. Practical means whatever you are observing, you have to draw that. So, ye char diagrams aapko banane hain. And again, I am saying these four diagrams are only for your guidance, not for your actual copy paste. So, aapko agar lagta hai ki wahan pe dikh raha hai, to just draw a terminal antheridia. अगर नहीं दिखा तो लीव इट, कोई जरूरत नहीं बनाने की. ठीक है?
ओके सर. यस सर.
चलिए, सो दैट्स इट फॉर आवर साइड.